This is WKTV Journal In Focus. I'm Ken Norris. In focus today is first-term State Representative Tommy Brann. Representative Brann is a Republican elected in November to serve District 77, which includes the city of Wyoming and Byron Township. Brann is a longtime local businessman, owning and operating several Brann's restaurants, and he has been active in support not only of the small business community, but local police and firefighters. Thanks for joining us today.
Ken, good to be here.
Very good. Hey, I would assume that initially going to Lansing as an elected official for the first time, you had some expectations about what would happen and how you would fit in. Talk a little about some of your initial experiences there.
Sure. Well, I've only missed five nights at my restaurant. I come back from Lansing, and we were there Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. I do think it possibly could be a part-time job. I mean, right now, July and August, I only go one day a month. I mean, geez, how's that right? And also, Sue and I are giving half our legislation salary back to the district for people in need, and that's been a great part of the job doing that. But when I go to Lansing, it is a long process. If you want to introduce a bill, you have to go through a committee, you got to pass through the committee, then you have to go to the House to get it passed through the House, pass through the Senate, and then the governor's got to sign it. I'm not saying that's bad or good. For my bills, it might be a little bit long, I think, sometimes, with that, I'm a little prejudiced that way, but I think it is a long process, and that's probably sometimes good.
Right. So talk about, you had mentioned some of the issues, some of the bills that you've introduced or want to introduce. I know that you've talked before about issues such as youth smoking, such as animal welfare, and also you were about ready to introduce a homeless advocacy bill.
Yeah, like my restaurant's a blue-collar restaurant, which I'm proud of, and I've been there 46 years, July 5th, my 46th year, and I'm not a big shot, and I work at my restaurant, and that's good for Lansing. So when I get to Lansing, I make some of these decisions. I think of my restaurant and my house down the street from Wyoming, that somebody's struggling to pay for groceries, so I make some of these decisions based on that. And some of my decisions are also some of my busboys smoking at young ages. I mean, we all know it's bad for you. And I thought maybe somebody missed this. I mean, smoking 21, why don't we raise it to drinking age? So I dropped a bill, it's bipartisan, to raise it to 21, and I didn't know it was gonna be so controversial. And I know the word freedom comes in there, freedom. I just look at this as freedom to live longer. Because 16,200 people die a year in Michigan from smoking-related diseases. 95% of them start under the age of 21. And once you start at 16 or 15 years old, it's hard to quit. And we spend $1.1 billion in Medicaid for smoking diseases every year. So this is just, it will save lives.
Right.
But it's
so what about this animal welfare bill that, if I understand it, has something to do with domestic violence and preventing or at least penalizing?
It does. This one I got passed through committee. Mm-hmm. Nobody voted against it. And now I got to get it on the floor. And this is about, Sue and I never had kids, and animals were a big part of our life, dogs. And I know I had some people, three girls about 25 years ago were in booth number 99. And they say the good way to get back with somebody is to kill their dog. And I said, God, I said, what the heck? So I took my name out of the phone book because I'm being a bar owner. I've barred people before. And I thought about that when I came to Lansing. I said, it's a loophole that you can get revenge on somebody by killing their pet and be on a tether. So I've got the Humane Society, Wayne County prosecutors are testified for it. And the sheriff from Genesee County testified for it, the cruelty to animals. And this makes it a stiffer penalty. And there's 100% MSU study that if you are cruel to an animal, you're going to be cruel to an adult, 100%. And it goes down from there. So this is going to make it, it's a good bill. I'm just hopefully I get on the House floor.
Very good. And you had mentioned something that you had just dropped a bill dealing with the homeless. What is
yeah,
that?
My dad started on Division Street in 1941 on Oaks and Division. And I remember my dad walking to church with him, and he was always bothered. This great country of ours to have homeless people. That bothered him. And I'm in Lansing now, so maybe I can have some positive influence on this. And so the problem is that homeless people, it's something that just a tragedy. The car doesn't start and they miss work and they don't have a job. Well, a tragedy, that might sound simple, but to a single mom or father that's trying to make it, that's a big tragedy. And then they're kicked out of their house. This bill would have landlords lower their rent, and they would get a tax break for lowering their rent. Uh-huh. And so it would be like with nonprofits helping too, and it would hopefully give rent affordable for homeless people so they can get their feet back on the ground. So
It seems that all of these issues are involved with maybe something that things that are not immediately on the public's attention, but you see as being good for the community. I mean, I wouldn't say they're not obscure things, not at all. But they're maybe not they're not taxes, they're not roads, they're not that sort of thing. I mean, do you see that as a first-term representative? That's a place that maybe you can be a little more selective in where you're advocating.
Right. I mean, we still have problem with the roads, so we still have to.
Yep.
We got the M6 moved up. So they're taking care of that. So we still have some problems, but it's back to my restaurant, being a blue-collar restaurant, myself being a blue-collar worker. That, I don't know, I see this at my restaurant. Like, we had a girl across the street at Fat Man's Misty, and she was eating out of a dumpster, and I was going to get some pancake mix for our breakfast bar because we were low on it, and I stopped and I said, I didn't know her that time. I said, don't do that. You know, you're going to get sick. So I brought her over to my restaurant. We fed her, and she didn't have shoes on. This is the wintertime. And we got her warm, gave her coffee. And Leah, my bartender, went and got some shoes from her house. I mean, that's what a great people I have working for me. And then Wyoming police came, and they took her to Mel Trotter's. But it's so sad, too, because she has some issues, mental issues. But this is what I see at my restaurant sometimes, and this is good for me in Lansing, because I can take this and move it to Lansing and bring this up to my colleagues.
Very good.
I'm not a big shot. I mean, believe me, if you have a cold baked potato in my restaurant, which we've done before, I hate letting people down. If you have a cold baked potato in my restaurant, it shows you that I'll be at the table and you'll be bawling me out, Ken. And you should. I mean, you're supposed to have a hot baked potato.
Yeah. Okay. So, talking about your business a little bit, I know you're a big advocate of small business issues, both in Wyoming and in Lansing. And I'm curious, do you think that people in Lansing, the state government, do they have a grasp of small business issues, or is that something that maybe you can help and want to sort of educate a little more on?
Yeah, you know, whenever people run for office, it's all about jobs, and it should be. Jobs are so important, but people say, yeah, I had a small business, and small business owners are really looked upon in a good light in Lansing, and actually in Washington, D.C. I mean, we're the backbone of this country. I mean, we supply over 60% of the jobs. We take a risk. We have, you know, we pay property taxes, we pay our taxes, but I think Lansing, they don't misunderstand us, they like us, but sometimes I like to keep it simple. In Lansing, there's so many moving parts. I mean, I'm on appropriations for license regulations, and I just don't know how our state keeps track of everything. And my business, being a restaurant owner, I know if we put too many things on our menu, like we used to have 108 items on our menu, I mean, it's hard keep it simple. And I'm a big Steve Jobs fan. And we pared it down. So I think Lansing should take a little small business lessons and understand small business that way too, keeping things simple and being focused.
Very good. Okay, last thing I want to talk about.
You have to title your show, Focus.
Focus, in focus. Yeah. Thank you for mentioning
that.
So the last thing I want to talk about is that I know you and your brother are big advocate, big supporters for first responders, police and firefighters. And I guess I just want to, how is the family, why is the family, such big supporters?
Yeah, I guess what am I missing here? Why wouldn't anybody support that? I mean, it's people, good people they're the good guys and gals. My brother Johnny, I give really him credit. If you go to Leonard Street Brands, he's got flags on the building with his own money of the fallen police officers and the fallen soldiers, like Eric Burry. His dad, John, lives right down the street from my place on Division on 50th. So he's really the front lines on that also for us. And you go to this place sometime, Leonard, and it's really a tribute to the police and fire and also our soldiers.
Very Very good. Well, thank you very much for joining us today, sir. I appreciate it.
No, no problem, Ken. Glad to be here.
Very good. This has been WKTV Journal In Focus. I'm Ken Norris. Thanks for joining us today, and remember, learn more and get involved.